Good afternoon, guys, and thank you for watching my channel if you just started. Today I'm going to teach you how to make homemade deodorant. And the cool thing about this is most of this is all organic, so it's not bad for you. And so far, it makes up quite a bit. So you're going to have enough to last for a while. I won't, if this works, because I've already been using it 2 days, okay. If it works well, you'll probably never go to the store again. Because it's so easy to make at home. So all you need to make your own deodorant, which it's going to look like this consistency after you're done, which is fine. You're going to need cornstarch. We're going to just dive right into it. And I was talking to this girl at work. I was telling her, I'm like, we're, you know, discussing being bigger. Big ladies have issues with sweating. I was telling her that the deodorants in the store just don't do it. Which, by the way, if you want to measure this out, you can or have to. Just know that however much you put in this bowl is going to be how much it makes. So, right here, this is probably like, I don't know, a third of a scoop. When I was making it earlier, I used one of these to do it. It was easier. Okay, your next ingredient will be, and this one didn't surprise me at all. I think I was more surprised that you used coconut oil in it. But you're gonna use baking soda. Again, same measurement. And then we're gonna use coconut oil. I'm going to set you down for a second because coconut oil cap. Yeah, right. So, I'm going to set you down here. We're going to use that much coconut oil, guys. Essential oils you like, in my case, rose, vintage rose. You can pick them up at Walmart, they're cheap. They can go in the Scentsy, you can go in anything. You also can use a eucalyptus. Some people like vanilla in there, some people like to use, in this case mine's blue agave, love it. It doesn't matter what essential oil you put in there, lavender, it's really your choice. And then I added alum. Alum is a preservative that they use in canning, but it's also going to be used in this deodorant. Okay, now you have an option, okay? You can use Vicks if you want. You don't have to. It's not in there. I just happen to like the feeling, so to speak. It's an option. But then I just put a tiny scoop of Vicks in, like a tiny, tiny scoop, like that much. It's breathable. It'll give you that aha moment. We're going to add in blue agave. I'm just going to do like 3 to 4 or 5 or 6 drops. If you smell it after and you don't feel like it's got enough scent to it, you can add more. And then you have an option after this is done, okay? If you wanted to refrigerate this, you can. And make it solid. I would refrigerate it for about maybe an hour and take it out, but it's meant to be left out. You don't need to refrigerate it all the time or anything like that. It's meant to be left out. You can set it in your bathroom like you do your regular deodorant, and then we're gonna mix it. Okay, The cool thing about the alum is as it goes on and on, it will help harden it too. This stuff is so super cool. So we're just going to mix it until it gets a good consistency. It is going to be smooth, and that's okay. You're just going to rub it on. Be mindful, it could get on your clothes, but we're going to be okay with that. And then when you're finished, you're going to scoop it into these little jars. I use miniature mason jars. I like them. They're easier for storage. You can take a permanent marker to the cap so you remember what it is. It's just nice, convenient, all that, whole nine yards. To me, it gets like a frosting type. It looks like frosting is the best way to put it when it's done. But it rubs on kind of like lotion, nice and smooth. No weird afterness. It's just good. So, I hope you guys enjoyed what I showed you how to make. Hope it works out for you. Obviously, if you have any allergic reactions to any of these ingredients, don't make it. It's probably not for you. But I hope that it works out. You don't need to go wild on it either when you're making it or when you're putting it on your skin. Give me 1 second, I'm just washing off my fingers. Washes off really easy too. So it's not gonna be like clogging your pores and making you be like, oh, what have I done? This is gross. No, not like that at all. So, after you're finished, it should look like this. Again, you can refrigerate it if you would like, or you can write on the top what it is and then put it in your bathroom. And see, the mixture I made is about enough for 2 jars. Hope you guys like this. Have a good week.